HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by the Dentist at Hopkinton. Founded by Dr. Jill Tanzi in 2003, the Dentist at Hopkinton provides state-of-the-art dental care in a comfortable and relaxing setting to patients of all ages. They are located at 77 Main Street and online at hopdent.com. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School. It's Hopkinton Hillers girls basketball on HCAM. And today they are going to take on the Millis Mohawks. Millis is 6-1. Hopkinton is 3-1. Tom Nappy alongside Steve Spector on the call tonight. And it should be a good TVL battle between two battle-tested, talented teams. Should be a fun one tonight, Steve.
Yeah, looking forward to it, Tom. Great to do the game with you here tonight. It's my first girls' game of the year, so I'm going to get a little bit familiar with some of the new names, but I certainly, looking at the roster, there's some really really talented Hiller girls coming back after last year's season. And Millis, certainly 6-1, is off to a good start. So I think, you know, the Hillers, after only playing four games versus seven, you know, they're probably geared up to play a big game against a Tri-Valley League rival, so look forward to it.
Should be a fun one. Right now we'll send it down to courtside for the opening announcements.
On the hometown Hopkinton Hillers. Hopkinton High School in the Tri-Valley League is committed to the highest ideals of sportsmanship and establishing a healthy environment for interscholastic competition. We will not tolerate negative statements or actions directed towards competitors, coaches, game officials, or fans in attendance. Please make sure your behavior reflects respect towards everyone. And now for tonight's starting lineups. First, for the visiting Millis Mohawks. Number 4, junior Abby Miller. Number 11, senior Kayleen Adams. Number 12, junior Courtney Bickford. Number 13, junior Erin Rice. And number 23, senior Haley Roach. The Mohawks are coached by Paul Geary, Howie Ingraham, Dale Mackey, Olivia Zatoli, Steve Cassidy, and head coach Dave Fallon. And now for the hometown Hopkinton Hillers. At guard, number 22, sophomore Kiki Fossbender. At guard, number 23, sophomore Lauren Cho. At forward, number 33, sophomore Lexi Trendle. At forward, number 21, junior captain, Caroline Cadell. And at guard, number 5, senior captain, Olivia Gladue. The Hillers are coached by Kerry Chatton, Chaney Gaudette, Will Collins, and head coach Mike Greco. If you could now please rise for the playing of our national anthem.
We'll be right back.
And we are ready for basketball. The Hopkinton Hillers and the Millis Mohawks. Tom Nappy alongside Steve Spector. The Hillers coming off a 44-39 loss to Westwood. Their first loss of the season. And Kiki Fossbender in that game had 24 points. But despite the 24-point effort, the Hillers came up just short against Westwood. And I think a key tonight for the Hillers is going to be to have more than Kiki Fossbender contribute scoring-wise.
Well, it's going to be good. You know, again, starting from last year, the Hillers were, they had a bunch of freshmen, and those freshmen are now sophomores with, not just sophomores, but you know, experienced sophomores. So, you know, along with Olivia Gladue coming back after sort of an injury-plagued season last year, I think the future's looking bright to have a good season this season for the Hiller girls.
Haley Roach wins the tip-off for Millis, and the Mohawks have it first. As Bickford drives in, feeds the top of the perimeter to Kayleen Adams. Adams with two defenders in front of her in trouble as the Hillers switched to zone. Now driving it off the glass and in goes Haley Roach, the senior.
Tough shot. Tallest player on the court for Millis.
Millis with the press to start things off here, trying to draw up those turnovers, as they've done so well this season, as Lauren Cho feeds it up to the left wing, driving in and knocking it down. Kiki Fossbender, the sophomore star.
Wow, stop and pop, beautiful shot.
Abby Miller with possession for the Mohawks. Feeds it over to Bickford. Now up top to Adams, who launches the three, no good. Hiller's rebound there to collect is Caroline Connell.
Nice box by Caroline.
Here comes Cho, around a defender up with the left hand. Millis basketball.
Lauren kind of ran over the Millis player there. That was definitely an offensive foul.
Yeah, a bit of a, you know, they will give her the foul, but also certainly a bit of a travel.
Might have traveled before the offensive foul, but.
Haley Roach inbounds Abby Miller. Miller feeds it over to Bickford. Now up top to Aaron Rice. I've been told this Millis team has a whole lot of speed, and that is what has led to their success, as Abby Miller has it knocked out of her hand, out of bounds. Another Hillers foul. They get Lauren Cho with her second.
Actually, it's Alexi Trendle, actually.
Excuse me, that was Cho with the earlier foul, Trendle with that one. Abby Miller has it knocked away by Cho, regains possession. Feeds it over to the left corner to Bickford. Bickford down the lane, feeds the wing, up for three, no good is Rice. A battle for the ball as Gladue and Bickford fall to the floor, and we'll get a jump ball call.
Yeah, it's a pretty critical game for the Hillers that haven't played in a little bit, or that you mentioned they haven't played a lot of games, so facing Millis, who historically has had strong seasons in the Tri-Valley League and once, you know, gone to the state championship games, have a good history of that, so Hillers are going to bring their A-game today.
Yeah, this Millis girls program has had a lot of success. Trendle driving in, up with the right hand, and in, count it.
Tough shot. Kind of weaved her way through there.
Some nice movement by Trendle to slip through a couple of defenders and put up the second field goal of the night for the Hillers. Abby Miller with possession, trying to feed it in the lane to Kayleen Adams. It was knocked away by Gladue, but regained by Bickford on the corner. She'll feed it up to Miller, running out of time on the shot clock is Millis, driving in, up with the layup, no good, off the side of the hoop. Gladue's there for the loose ball. Here comes Cho. Cho feeds it over to Fossbender. Now back to Gladue. Cho now with possession along the wing, going to drive in around a number of defenders. Ooh. Up, no good. It's a Millis rebound. Haley Roach pulls it down. A wide open look at the basket for Cho, but she just couldn't finish. Erin Rice feeds it up to Abby Miller, and now over to Roach. And Roach, as she dribbles in, we're going to get a little foul here. And it's going to be against the Hillers. That's already a team third for Hopkinton.
On Olivia.
Get Olivia Gladue. Adams on the entry. Gets the pass back now from Miller. Up top to Rice, driving the lane.
Looks like an offensive.
And what looked like an offense doesn't seem like it's going to be an offensive foul.
Wow. I mean, Olivia had position. She was 2 feet planted, got run over. But there was also, let's say, Caroline Connell was also involved. So I got Caroline in that foul.
Bickford at the line. Four fouls on the Hillers already. Bickford misses the first free throw. A 4-2 lead for the Hillers. 4:46 left to go in the first quarter.
Millis has a whole bunch of players like the same height, 5'6", 5'7", for the most part. A nice second free throw goes down. And Hillers, if they can take advantage of Caroline and some of the other taller players, that'll be a bit of an advantage they can work to their in their favor.
Cho going to drive down the lane, up at the underhand lane, and she'll draw contact.
Cho showing a little more strength that last year as a freshman. You can see she's definitely doing a great job blossoming beautifully as a sophomore here. And
you got Aaron Rice with the foul as Cho misses the first free throw.
Certainly counting on her to have a big season.
Oh, absolutely. She was a fun player to watch last season. She should just keep getting better and better.
Ooh, nice.
Put back, no good by Trendle, but the Hillers are able to keep possession as Connell was there to collect a loose ball. Now to Cho, launches a three, no good. And Trendle is there to collect once again. Good rebounding by the Hillers. An air ball by Cho out of bounds. And it will stay with the Hillers. They call it out on the Mohawks.
Well, and Cho certainly getting her opportunities, just not going down quite yet, but plenty of time in the game here. 4:20 left, 4-3 Hillers. 4:20 left in the first quarter, I should say.
Pass up top to Murphy. Now to Cho, feeds it in to Hardenbrook.
Oh.
Back to Cho, little mishandle there. Here goes Caroline Mundy for Millis, and she'll take it all the way, but can't finish. Cho with the pass up into the lane to Trendle. Trendle up
nice.
With the left hand and in. How about Lexi Trendle lately? She's been huge for the Hillers as Millis trying to respond quickly. A pass that got a little bit away from Caroline Mundy. Hillers basketball.
I want to sort of point out Lulu Murphy in the game. She made a really nice defensive play right before Lexi hit that last hoop. Didn't get herself in a compromised position. She played great defense on the layup, and Hillers got the ball back and brought the ball up, and Lexi hit a nice shot there.
Already a pair of field goals for Lexi tonight. Cho trying to work it up. Now to Murphy, back to Cho. Trying to feed it to the corner, but there was a pair of defenders there getting a hand on it. It was Mundy, and then we'll have a jump ball as Cho and Mundy get wrapped up. It'll be Millis basketball. Georgia Jalasco, the junior, just topped into the game on the inbound. Abby Miller will take it up. Miller feeds it to the corner to Bickford. And now into Rice. Nice. Off the glass and in goes Rice.
Tough shot.
A 6-5 ball game. Millis continuing with the press. They've been relentless with the press throughout these early minutes. Murphy feeds it over to Cho. Cho trying to pass in to Trendle, but Aaron Rice read it very nicely. Here comes Millis. Miller feeds it to the wing to Bickford, up for a three, no good. A battle for the ball. Cho rips it away. Can she keep it in? No. She got tied up with Mundy and won the battle, but the ball ended up out of bounds.
That was borderline over the top on Cho, but the refs are, to their credit, letting the girls play here.
It's been a pretty physical game so far.
Yep.
Abby Miller on the entry. Feeds it to Jewett. Jewett calls it out. Now to Bickford, who launches the long two. That's no good. It'll rattle out. Hillers have it. And here comes Murphy.
Oh, nice recovery.
And Murphy lost her footing, but able to feed it over to Brooke Daugherty. Now Hardenbrook will go around the perimeter with it. Murphy back to Hardenbrook. And now Doherty. Murphy gets into the corner. Hiller's running out of time here. They got to get a shot off over the short corner. Trendle trying to drive the baseline and then trying to go up with it was Hardenbrook, but a defender got a hand on it, and that was a great defensive stand by the Mohawks.
Oh,
off the glass and in, Abby Miller. Well, Millis gets a great turnover, and then they take the lead, an 8-6 game. Trying to feed it in, knocked away once again by the defender, but it is picked up by Sensini.
Nice recovery by Amelia there.
Murphy with possession. Back to Amelia. Hiller's running out of time once again. The feed to Trendle trying to drive to the bucket, knocked out of bounds, contested by Bickford. Well, this Mohawks interior defense, Steve, I got to say, they're impressive.
It is impressive, and the Hillers are working the ball around beautifully. And, you know, the second or third time up in a row down the court for their possession, and they just can't seem to get a good shot off. Working the ball, and then Millis just kind of stymies them.
Murphy.
We got to get the ball. We got to shoot it.
And she'll shoot, but it's no good. Brooke Doherty on the three attempt. Out of bounds it goes, Millis basketball.
1:42 left, 8-6 Millis. Hillers haven't scored in a little while.
Kayleen Adams takes it up. Adams around the defender, up and draws the foul from Kylie Hardenbrook.
Tough call on Kylie. I mean, she's doing everything right and moving with, didn't really do anything, the Millis player. Kind of created a lot of the contact, but Kylie was kind of moving along with her.
Adams misses the first of two.
Lexi Trendle taking a break. She had a nice first quarter so far.
Second free throw, got it. Millis up by three. Murphy feeds it over. Millis continuing with the full court pressure. Here goes Murphy driving in around the defender, up no good.
Oh, nice.
And it is collected by Doherty, who feeds it back up for the shot. Murphy, no, Millis has it. Here comes the Mohawks, quickly up court. Aaron Rice feeds it to the short corner, up and in goes Bickford.
Wow, that was a quick release by Bickford. She barely touched the ball, almost a touch shot. Oh, nice try.
Trying to get it to Amelia Sensini along the sideline, off her hand, out of bounds it goes. Mohawks will have the entry.
Cammie McDonald now the captain in the game for the Hillers.
Jewett takes it up.
There's a steal.
Knocked up by Murphy, nearly got away with it, but we have a foul call, and it will be against Millis.
Lulu Murphy having a good game. Spunky play, a lot of spark. Doing a good job taking care of the ball.
They got Grace Jewett with the arm grab. Murphy feeds it over to the corner to Hardenbrook. Now back to Murphy. Over to Sensini. Now over to the right corner. Up for three and an air ball by McDonald. Millis has it once again. The feed is up to Aaron Rice. She'll launch the deep two. Great block by Connell. Back and forth we go. A defensive affair so far. Connell driving in around the defender, up with the underhand shot, no good. Put back, no good. Ball batted up in the air a couple times and pulled down by Jelasco for Millis. Jewett feeds it out to Bickford.
15 seconds in the quarter.
An 11-6 lead for Millis, trying to add on with a potential buzzer beater. Rice drives the lane, feeds it to Bickford, up for three, no. It is collected by Jewett, and she tries to get the shot up, but Sensini got a hand on it. And that is how the first quarter will end after one. It is Millis 11, the Hillers 6. It's been kind of a defensive scrappy type of game, Steve.
Yeah, I would agree. Both teams playing tough D, and you know, Hillers working, like I said earlier, working the ball around nicely. Just can't seem to, you know, they get smothered by Millis when it comes time to shoot and maybe just trying a little too hard. Maybe just letting the game come to them a little bit. Millis, nice finish after being down. Comes out with an 11-6 lead. And again, as I said, 6 points. Not a great offensive output by the Hillers, but they haven't scored in about 4 minutes either. So hopefully, Coach Greco can get his crew rallied and get a little more organized. They worked a lot of players in that first quarter, so see if he funnels down a rotation with if he's going to play his whole bench again, because he played about 10 players that first quarter.
Well, it seems like the Hillers have had open opportunities from the interior. They just have not been able to finish. We have a good crowd on hand here tonight. For both sides, a lot of Millis fans in support as well. Lily Morningstar here to support her teammates. And we are ready for the second quarter. Can the Hillers get going offensively? They struggled big time in that first quarter. Mackenzie Fossbender in the Cho. And we're underway in quarter number two. Feeds it over to the corner to Connell. Now up to Fossbender, Gladeau. Feeds it to the block, up for the shot, and no good as Connell, but she'll draw contact. Nice job by Connell, two defenders in front of her, but she's able to reach up above them both.
Free throw is so critical, as you know, Tom. In the boys' game the other night, the Hillers ended up going into overtime. They didn't really shoot very well at the line all game, probably 50% maybe throughout the game. And you know, a lot of those misses were early, first, second quarter. And Caroline, unfortunately, misses the first one.
Hillers 0 for 3 so far tonight from the line. We'll see if the junior can change that now. No good. Millis has it. There to collect was Mia Molinari. Kayleen Adams with possession. Feeds it out to Miller.
Deep one.
And now a deep three attempt is no good by Julia Groton, and the Hillers have it. Cho takes it up. Over to Fossbender, and now Connell.
Oh,
good
nice
feed to Trendle, up and in. Lexi Trendle just waiting in the low post, able to take advantage. Groton launches the jumper. Off the window, no good. Millis rebound, put back. That's no good by Adams. And then we have a number of players get tied up, and we have a foul.
It's the Kayleen Adams, the number 11, with a foul, I believe. Lexi Trendle, for you young players who are watching this game, she's made some nice hoops so far. That was her third hoop of the night, I believe. And what she did there that was really worth noting is she had a great ball fake. That really fooled the Millis player, gave herself a beautiful open left-handed layup, and she nailed it.
Gladeau with possession, out of the corner, now back to Cho. Fossbender going to drive in, launches it, pretty hard off the glass there, and it's no good. Murphy there to collect for the Mohawks. Driving the lane, Miller, and she'll draw contact.
From Lexi.
That's the sixth team foul by the Hillers. Getting close to that limit.
Second on Lexi. We've got to keep an eye on that. Leading scorer, I think. She got 6 points out of the eight.
First to two is no good by Abby Miller. An 11-8 Millis lead. 6:40 left to go in the second quarter. Second free throw. No good. That'll rattle out. Collected by Fossbender. Here comes the Hillers. Cho. Back to Fossbender. Now Gladeau. Gladeau trying to find out where to go with it. Trying to get it to the top of the perimeter. It's stolen by Mundy. Driving down and drawing the foul, Aaron Rice.
That's a tough call on.
That was a good steal there by Mundy.
Like Lauren Cho's second foul. Kind of a prayer shot, so unfortunately for Lauren, she, I want to say, wasted a foul on that one, but that was unlikely to go in.
First of two is no good. It's a seventh team foul on the Hillers. Millis has four.
Both teams not doing well at the line, Tom.
Now a battle for the ball, and Caroline Connell comes away with it. Gladeau takes it up the near side. Feeds it over to Fossbender. And out Cho drives along the end line, then feeds it back out to Connell, and then Connell is going to hit and draw the foul on and one.
Tough shot. I mean, she's a right-handed player, and she somehow rolled it and kissed it off the glass with her left hand. Beautiful shot. I don't know what he's calling there. He's not giving her the hoop.
Yeah, looks like they're going to say the foul's before that shot.
I'm sorry. I don't agree with that one. I don't mean to be a homer, but that.
I don't agree with it either. Yeah. She got the shot off, I thought, as she was getting fouled.
Absolutely.
Hillers will inbound. Murphy on the entry off the hand of Groton. It goes,
nice.
And it is collected by Fassbender. Glideau feeds it up to Trendle. Now back to Glideau. Trendle now pump fakes, gets it inside to Connell.
There's some contact
now two
there.
Defenders, and that for sure is a foul. We'll get Julia Groton with her first.
Nice to see Caroline having a good season so far. Again, junior captain. I can remember a couple years ago, a freshman. She's definitely evolved nicely and only a junior, so she's got another year after this. That's great. Good news for the Hillers and not so good news for the rest of the Tri-Valley League.
Unfortunately tonight, though, she is 0 for 3 from the line. See if she could change that right here. There it is. An 11-9 game in favor of Millis. Andy Miller will take it up. Feeds Mundy, driving in. Off the glass, no good. Loose ball collected by Connell. Here comes the Hillers. Over to Fassbender. Around a pair of defenders. Off the glass and in.
Beautiful shot. A little Euro step.
That's her second field goal of the night. Miller with possession.
Ooh, nice
behind
move.
The back dribble around the defender. Up with the underhand left shot, no good. Mundy collects drills a three.
That's the second three-pointer off glass. I'm not sure if they're calling it, but doesn't really matter, I guess.
Here's Glideau. Over to Murphy, back to Glideau. Fassbender feeds it out. Murphy lost her dribble, picked up by Trendle. Off the board, no good. And Haley Roach comes away with it. Taking it up, Abby Miller. Over to Bickford. Back to Miller now. 15 seconds left on the shot clock.
Lulu Murphy causing trouble and caught a turnover. Good job.
Great turnover by the Hillers. Murphy battling for it. Out of bounds it goes. Millis basketball. She got tied up a little bit with Abby Miller.
Good sportsmanship by Miller, picking up Lulu off the ground. Lulu, good effort, trying to save the ball.
Roach on the entry to Miller. Bickford feeds it out. Rotten thought about the long two. Good pass over to Miller, got away from her. The Hiller is crowding the low post, it pays off. Murphy to Connell, now back to Murphy. Approaching 4 minutes left to go in the first half.
Ooh, a little travel there.
And we'll get Fassbender with the moving violation. Millis basketball.
Sometimes they let that go, Tom, and that was a little bit of a too obvious, and it was right in front of the ref, so. 14-11 Millis, 4:02 left in the half. Low-scoring affair so far.
Miller takes it up for the Mohawks. Over to Hubble, now Jalasco feeds Bickford. And we'll get a foul here, an offensive foul on Millis.
Georgia Agalasco, kind of a moving pick, her first foul. Oh, hello.
A misfire there, and a steal for the Mohawks. Here comes Abby Miller down the lane, off the glass, no good. And McDonald almost had it back, but ripping it away was Bickford. Feeds it out, up for the long two, and no good is Abby Miller. And now a battle in the low post for the ball. Fassbender gets wrapped up, and Millis calls a timeout.
Well, how can they call a timeout? They didn't have the possession of the ball. Sorry, Tom, I didn't mean to jump on that, but look at Coach Greco's got his hands up. How can you that's impossible to call a timeout. You can see by his body language. I mean, Fassbender ended up with a ball. It wasn't even a jump ball.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure about that one.
Yeah, I'm sure about it, and it was. So I would have to say the refs are overall calling a decent game, but they missed that one, unfortunately.
Well, so far in the first 4.5 minutes of the second quarter, the Hillers have outscored Millis 5-3, but they trail by 3. And this has been a very physical, defensive, kind of a sloppy game, I must say.
Yeah, it's scrappy. I guess scrappy defense. Both teams are working the ball around, using the shot clock, and then when it comes time to shoot, there's been a handful of block shots, but certainly there's been a lot of disrupted shots.
Yeah, I'm very impressed by the interior defense on both sides.
Yeah, I mean, Millis, if you think about it, they have 14 points. Six of those points, Tom, are off of 2 3-pointers that were banked in, which I'm not going to say there was a little luck involved, but I'm sure unlikely they were called off glass. But certainly a close game. We'll probably have a tight finish as we go through the game here. And Millis taking the ball out underneath.
Rossi's trying to feed it over. It got away from her intended target, Abby Miller. Here comes the Hillers as Murphy launches the shot. No good. Out of bounds it goes. On the entry, Glasgow to Miller. Miller feeds it over to Bickford. Back to Miller on the give and go, and it'll roll off the rim.
Look,
and it's collected by McDonald. Here comes McDonald. Good job looking behind her at the defender. Up for 3, no good there is Fassbender. And the Mohawks have it back as Jelasco was there to recover. But now contesting is Fassbender. A little push on Abby Miller. Ball went out of bounds off of Fassbender. Miller's basketball.
Could have been a little bit of a foul there on Fassbender, but the refs maybe a makeup non-call off of the jump ball.
Yeah, they're letting him play out there, that's for sure.
Yeah.
But I agree, that probably should have been a foul. Jelasco on the entry to Miller. Here comes Miller. Down the lane, knocked away, and we have a push call.
Look at Coach Greco, his hands are palms up. How could that be? And I would have to – I didn't really see a whole lot there.
Well, the officials can see a lot more than we can. They're a lot closer. We'll give them the benefit of the doubt on that one.
I guess with your permission, I'll let that one go. But I guess it's too late now.
Doesn't matter what we think anyway.
Yeah, that's true.
It's a one and one for Abby Miller. 18 fouls on the Hillers. And she hits the front end. Miller on the back end of a one and one. No good that time, and the Hillers have it, collected by McDonald. Cho takes it up.
Miller swarming defense, really making it hard for the Hillers to get anything going here.
Yeah, they're getting right in front of them, that's for sure. Cho drives along the end line, up for the lane, no good. Hillers rebound, up goes McDonald, no good. Cho able to get it back. Feeds it out to Connell. Now back to Cho on the corner. She launches a 3. That's no good, and it's collected by Bickford. Bickford takes it up, feeds it over to Jewett, and then it got away from her, knocked out of bounds. Off of Millis, Hillers basketball.
2:18 left, 15-11 Millis. Just an offensive struggle for both teams, I think.
Cho surrounded by a pair of defenders.
Might need a timeout, but they got it. Worked it out.
Here comes Fassbender. Driving down. Off the glass.
Oh!
And in. What's a foul? Oh, wait a minute. Was it?
They called an offensive foul on that one, Tom.
That one I don't like. That was a clean drive all the way.
That was just, if anything, it was a non-call. It's a heck of a shot by Fassbender. Not getting any benefits of the home court there. Not that you should, but that was pendulum swung the other way there. It's a little too far, in my opinion.
Miller takes it up. Over to Adams. And we have another foul.
Oh, my goodness. can hear Coach Greco from here, even through the headphones. He is not happy.
I'm a little speechless right now myself.
That's two really questionable calls. Usually when you have a questionable call, you try to make up for it. Not that you really should do that either, but, you know, to have two really questionable calls back-to-back is tough.
Double bonus time for Millis. And Kayleen Adams hits the first of two. On the second, no, falls out, and it's collected by McDonald. Here comes Cho, driving in around the defender, and shot no good, but there is a foul. And this time, they'll give the Hillers the benefit of the doubt.
Well, 16-11, 1:51 left in the half. Really use a couple of freebies here from Lauren.
They get Grace Jewett with her second foul. Cho on the first of two, no good. Hillers struggling from the line so far tonight. They are 1-for-7.
Oof, tough stuff.
No good there. Abby Miller collects. Feeds it up to Jewett. And Jewett draws up a little body contact with Fossbender, but they're going to get Jewett with the push.
I would call that one a makeup call. A makeup non-call, because that looked like a foul on Fossbender, and the ref, right in front of the ref, Miller's player just kind of said, well, how could that be?
Well, I guess there's been some questionable calls in both directions.
Yeah, you know, it's too bad we got to focus on the refereeing as opposed to the play. That's a tough pass right there.
Good steal by Adams, but an errant pass to Abby Miller. Hillers get it back. 1:25 left to go in the quarter. Hillers trailing by five. Cho takes it up. Looking towards Fossbender, and now is going to feed it back as Fossbender was covered up. Fossbender going to take it in, puts up the shot, no good, and Jewett collects for Millis. Grace Jewett feeds it over to Adams. Adams contested by Hardenbrook.
Good D.
Very good D on both sides. Bickford driving in. Up for the right-handed hook shot, no good, collected by Connell. Here comes Cho, driving the lane, no good there. She is struggling so far tonight from the low post. Miller takes it in, and she can't finish either, and nearly is able to steal it back from Connell, but a nice job by Connell hanging on. Cho feeds it over to Fossbender, now in the interior to McDonald, back out to Fossbender, nearly stolen. Now it is stolen as Caroline Mundy will pick up the loose ball. Takes it down court, coast to coast, up and in.
That's unfortunate there. 10 seconds in the half.
Cho with possession. Hillers hoping to hit a buzzer beater for some momentum here. The shot, no good by Fossbender. And that'll do it for the first half. Overall, a very good defensive performance by both sides, but a little bit sloppy on the offensive side, Steve.
Yeah, just, you know, you could look at the shooting and the free throws you alluded to, was they're 1-for-8 or something like that. You know, even if you go half, you know, you split the difference, you know, down. I think the Hillers are fortunate to be only down by 7. Nobody's really taking the ball. Fossbender, who had a big game the last game, not really doing a whole lot so far. Lexi Trendle, I think, with a few hoops. So hopefully the Hillers can kind of regroup at halftime and get a little bit more offensive game in play, and hopefully Coach Greco can get them motivated to do that. Millis, again, tough. They're a tough team, 6-1, so they're backing it up, and they definitely playing tough D on the Hillers.
Well, we shall see what the second half will bring. A whole lot of basketball left to be played. At the halftime break, it's Millis 18, the Hopkinton Hillers 11. You're tuned in to Hopkinton Hillers Girls Varsity Basketball on HCAM, second half, minutes away. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by the dentist at Hopkinton. The dentist at Hopkinton provides services including comprehensive dental care, same-day crowns, facial aesthetics, periodontal care, cosmetic dentistry, and implant dentistry. The dentist at Hopkinton is located at 77 Main Street,
and online at hopdent.com.
Yeah, the band. Thank you very much. We just have one quick announcement to make. We have our long-standing drummer, Ray Elwood, had a little surgery a few weeks back, and he's on the mend, and he says hello to everybody, but he couldn't be here today. But we have this amazing drummer, Pete Primo, good friend of the band's, and he's doing a great job, and we really appreciate him joining us today. So please make him feel welcome.
If I can reach the stars, pour one down for you, shine it in my heart, so you can see the truth, that this love I had inside is anything it seems. But for now, only in my dreams I can't change. He hates the world. I would be the sunlight in your universe. You would think my love was really something good. Maybe if I could change. Oh.
Back to the Hopkinton High School Athletic Center. We are just about ready for the second half of this TVL matchup between the Millis Mohawks out of the TVL small and the Hopkinton Illers out of the TVL large. An 18-11 Millis lead as we head into the second half. Let's take a look at the scoring total so far. Well, not a whole lot of scoring in that first half for either side, but for the Illers, Caroline Connell with 1, Mackenzie Fossbender with 4, Lexi Trendle with 6. For Millis, Abby Miller with 3, Caroline Mundy with 5, Kayleen Adams with 2, Cordy Bickford with 2, Aaron Rice with 4, Haley Roach with 2. And we are set for the second half. Can the Hillers offense pick it up? They're certainly going to need to if they want to take down this 6-1 Millis team.
The Millis definitely a steady team, tough D. Ooh, that could have been an offensive foul right there. Ref's letting that one go.
A miss by Haley Roach, and Lexi Trendle gathers it up. Here comes Cho. Over to Trendle. Up goes Fossbender. No good. Put back.
Nice.
Yes. Well, that is certainly a good way to start the second half if you're the Hillers. Millis trying to respond. There's a three by Adams. Nice. That's no good.
Nice box by Caroline there.
Here comes Cho. Driving in up with the underhand shot. No good. Collected by Kayleen Adams.
Cho is just having a tough time in the low post. But if she can get going, look out. Feeds it over to Miller. Pump fakes, drives in.
Oh, nice pass.
And a good pass to Haley Roach, who finishes. Cho takes it up. Over to Fossbender. Across to Gladeau. And out to Connell. Back up to Cho. Fossbender for three. That's no good.
Nice by Caroline. I'm sorry, by Lexi.
Yeah, good rebound there by Lexi. Tries to put it back. It was no good. And then we'll have a jump ball call as Fossbender and Roach got wrapped up. It'll be a Hiller's inbound. Trendle on the entry. Feeds it to Connell. Now up to Gladeau. It's poked away to Cho. Now over to Connell.
Oh, too bad.
Across to Fossbender, and she's contested and then is going to get wrapped up with Bickford.
Pass kind of ended up in her ankles, and tough to recover from that, and then Millis jumped on it, caused a jump ball there.
Roach on the entry to Adams. Adams takes it in. Feeds it up now. Over to Miller, who thought about the three. She'll feed it up to Adams, who launches the three. Off the front of the rim it goes. Cho collects. Cho takes it in.
Tough shot there for
an air ball there, collected by Adams, who will feed it to Miller. Good ball distribution by the Mohawks. There with the finish is Erin Rice.
That was a beautiful touch pass. They got the Millis coaching staff off the bench. That was a beautiful fast break.
Trendle drives in up for the shot. That's no good. Loose ball, and it's collected by Millis for the moment, then knocked out of bounds on the Hillers. It was a good hustle there by Kayleen Adams for the Mohawks.
All of a sudden, a nine-point deficit, Tom. You know, we got to get a hold of things here. This could get out of hand.
I hate to say it. The Hillers are just having all kinds of trouble in the low post hitting any type of shot. Abby Miller takes it up. Feeds it back to Adams. Down to the corner to Bickford. She'll drive in. Off the glass. No good. Great rebound there by Jalasco. And Jalasco tries to put it up and will draw contact with Trendle. First foul by either side in this second half as Georgia Jalasco heads to the line, the junior. First of two, no good.
Boy, both teams kind of a slugfest at the line here, Tom. I know the Hillers haven't done much at the line. Millis hasn't done much either.
Hillers were 1-for-8 in the first half from the line. Millis 4-for-12. And Millis now 4-for-14. Gladeau feeds it over to Cho. Now to the
skip
corner
pass
to Fossbender. We'll skip it over to Gladeau. Around the horn they go. Into Connell. Running out of time on the shot clock. Gladeau with an open shot. And it's no good. It is collected by Fossbender. Now over to Connell, around the defender, up, and no! They just can't get a break tonight. Collected by Miller.
Tough spot, like a cover on the rim for him.
It looked like it was just about to go in, decided, nah. And Georgia Jalasco with a good response there off the glass.
Timeout here, yeah, that's a good idea by Coach Greco.
It certainly is. All the momentum is tipping towards Millis, who now leads it 24-13 with 4:27 left. It's unbelievable. This Hillers girls team is typically a pretty good shooting team, but tonight they're just getting no breaks.
Well, you know, the tight rims and just unlucky at the as far as the you can't really defend the foul shooting because there's no one defending those shots, but that's just practice and mental preparation and finding a routine and sticking with it, but unfortunately, 13 points with 4:27 left in the third quarter, and only 13 points. That's tough stuff. But we want to acknowledge the legend Coach Bliss and his buddy Mike Connor taking care of the clocks over there.
doing a great job as always.
We've got some airtime for the Hopkinton student section.
Pretty good turnout tonight for this big TVL clash. Millis and Hopkinton. Well, the Hillers need to get some offense going. And we'll see if they could do just that.
You know, I think it's fair to say that the Hillers are still a fairly young team. They only have two seniors on the roster. Started three sophomores. And hate to see the shooting percentage from the field, but
a steal here. And Rice is going to drive up and finish. Good steal by Rice. She read that pass perfectly.
I mean, for the younger players, she read the pass well because it was sort of telegraphed, and that led to the turnover.
Cho feeds it over to Fossbender. Now back to Cho. Trying to get it in to Hardenbrook, and we'll have a Millis foul.
3:50 left in the third quarter. 26-13 doubled up on the Hillers. So I'd say it's a critical juncture in the game. The Hillers are going to either get things back into, you know, going in their direction, or this could be a long rest of the game here.
That foul's on Kayleen Adams. It's her third. Godot trying to feed it over. Knocked out of bounds by Abby Miller, who nearly picked off the pass. Hillers are going to switch up the talent on the floor, see if they can get something going.
Lulu Murphy and Brooke Doherty now in the game for the Hillers. They both bring a lot of energy.
Fossbender up to Murphy. Now Doherty. Back to Murphy. Doherty along the wing will feed it to the corner to Connell. Now to Murphy, driving in, and it's stripped away and collected by Bickford. Here comes Millis on a quick break. Abby Miller around the defender, up and in, but it will not count. She was called for the travel.
Good recovery by Brooke Doherty after a tough pass. Again, Millis just swarming D. Hopkinton really having a tough time just working the ball around right now.
Off the hand of Murphy, and it's collected by Bickford. Another turnover. Abby Miller takes it up. Miller feeds it out to the corner, an open look, no good by Rice. It is collected by Jelasco, goes up with it. That's no good. And then getting tied up under the hoop was Abby Miller along with Fossbender for the jump ball call. It'll be a Hillers inbound. Millis has backed off the press in the last few minutes of this game because they're just concentrating on guarding the interior because the Hillers are just struggling so much offensively.
Yeah, that's tough stuff. I hope they can get there tonight and the rest of the season. This is not a good indication of how they can work the ball around. Tough shot.
Doherty will drive in, up for the shot. No good. Collected by Jewett. Of course, it's a very young season. A long way to go.
Yep.
Bickford feeds it back. Now Adams trying to decide where to go with it.
Good D by the Hillers right here.
Over to Mundy, who's contested, picked up by Adams, and we're going to get a foul here. Not quite sure who that one's going to be on.
It's on Kylie Hardenbrook.
That will be her second. There's some pushing on both sides. Going for that loose ball. Adams on the entry.
Ooh.
A misfire towards Jewett. Jewett to Mundy. Mundy driving in, nearly stripped away. Up to Adams, who thought about the shot. Adams continuing to dribble with it, and who knows, maybe wasting clock might be in the strategy here for Millis.
Down to 6 seconds. I think she lost it.
And Jewett could not keep control, so the Hillers draw a nice turnover. 2:05 left to go in the third quarter. The Hillers trailing by 13. The feed is to Doherty. Now across to Sensini, and it's stripped away. Here comes Millis. Adams takes it up. And she'll stop, pop, drop the shot right in.
Coach Greco not happy with an uncontested. She had all the, I'm sorry, who hit that last shot?
That was Kayleen Adams.
Adams had just a wide open, had it all day long just to get herself set. Nobody contested it, and Coach Greco not happy with that. I was about to say before that hoop that, you know, as tough a night as Hoppington is having offensively, Millis isn't exactly hitting the cover off the ball either. I'm glad I didn't say that because they just hit a nice shot there. But certainly 28-13, a low-scoring game in general. 13 points, tough stuff right there. But I guess you have to credit Millis's D is definitely a major factor in the 13 points. You could say the shooting's not great, but if they can't get the shots off, that's part of the formula as well. So,
well, this Mohawks defense is impressive, that's for sure. And their hustle has been tremendous. And they're fighting for it, I feel like, more than the Hillers are. And the Hillers typically are hustling like Millis, but I think the fact that they're not shooting well is just kind of hurting their mentality a little bit.
Yep. Well, you know, looking for, like you mentioned, Kiki Fossbender had 24 points or so in the previous game. They don't have anybody tonight that they can rely on. I don't know how she got those points, if they're inside or outside, but certainly down by 15 points, you definitely need a couple of the three-pointers to get a quick start. Is Lulu, oh, too bad.
She's nearly stripped away by Mundy, and now she is. Mundy will cover it up and then get wrapped up with Murphy, but the timeout call comes in from the Millis sideline just before, so the Mohawks will have the ball.
Boy, another frustrating possession by the Hillers, just cross half court and couldn't really even work the ball around. You know, Millis, as I said, a bunch of kind of medium-sized players, but they all have a lot of grit and just causing a lot of disruption collectively, and the score supports that. So,
well, with 1:35 left to play, 28-13 lead for Millis. Of course, plenty of time left. But this Hillers offense has been quiet all night. They scored 11-6 in the first quarter, 7-5 in the second. And in this quarter so far, they've been outscored 10-2.
Want to take a minute here and acknowledge our staff taking care of everybody here. John Ritz, Mike Tarosian, Tom Dings, and Samantha Dings, thank you very much, as always, for keeping us in line for the most part. There's a nice shot of John.
The A-team. Off the timeout, the Mohawks will inbound. Kayleen Adams on the entry. Feeds it over to Rice. Up for the shot, no good, and the Hillers have it as Sensity is there. Here comes Hopkinton. Over to Doherty. Now on the corner is Connell. Back up to Doherty.
Oh, tough pass.
Poked in the air by Murphy, but able to collect it with Sensity. Good ball distribution. Turnaround jumper is no good by Hardenbrook. And then Connell will be contested on the rebound attempt by Jewett. We'll get the jump ball call. It'll be in favor of Millis. Rice on the entry. Here comes Miller. We'll see if the Hillers start to press a little more to try to drop some turnovers with time quickly
nice
running out. Good block there as Jewett tries to drive in. Here comes Murphy. Murphy over to Hardenbrook, launches the deep two. That's no good. And then a battle along the far sideline, but it went out of bounds. It'll be a Hillers inbound.
Good hustle by Lulu Murphy on that, knocking the ball off the Millis player's leg to maintain possession. 46.9 seconds left in the third quarter, Tom. Down by 15. I guess you kind of hope they can get a hoop. Any hoop would be great. They only have 2 points this quarter, which is hard to say, but that's what they have.
Well, they can get hot at any moment, right?
Exactly.
Cho gives it off to Sensity. Back to Cho. Driving in. That's out to Doherty. Launches a three. No good. Off the back iron. Tipped in the air a couple of times by Bickford, then collected by Miller. Here comes Millis. Pass over to Grutton, who will feed it out to the top of the perimeter. Up for three, no good as Adams. Batted in the air, and this time the Hillers come up with it as Hardenbrook's there to collect.
15 seconds.
Joe takes it up, feeds it over to Sensity. Out to the wing to Doherty. And now across to Sensity on the skip, and now Cho going to drive in. Up with the underhand shot, and she hits one.
There we go. A little bit more. Any kind of momentum is a good thing, and good to see Lauren hit a basket there.
Well, that was certainly a well-needed field goal by the Hillers, and certainly, I'm sure, gave some confidence to the sophomore Lauren Cho, who's been struggling a bit from the low post, but a good drive-in score there for Cho to end the third quarter. And let's not forget, you still got 8 minutes left.
Exactly. Anything could happen. And again, Millis outscoring Hoppington 10-4 that quarter. And again, with Cho hitting the shot kind of with 2 seconds left in the quarter, we want to take a quick opportunity to say HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by the dentist at Hoppington. And the dentist at Hoppington provides services including comprehensive dental care, same-day crowns, facial aesthetics, periodontal care, cosmetic dentistry, and implant dentistry. The dentist at Hoppington is located at 77 Main Street and online at hopdent.com. And I'm just guessing that some of these players here maybe go to that to see the Dr. Jill Tansey there. She's been around since 2003 in town. We appreciate their support here.
Absolutely. The Hillers will have the inbound to start the fourth quarter. Cho on the entry. To the corner to Sensity. Now back up to Cho. And she was contested. And we're going to get a foul call here.
Another thing, Tom, to mention, look at the number of fouls in that third quarter as compared to the first half. It's both teams with two fouls apiece in this half, basically after the third quarter, whereas doesn't look like any team's going to be in bonus anytime soon.
An air ball by Sensity, but it's collected by Doherty. Doherty trying to figure out where to go with it. Gets back to Cho. Now to Sensity. Launches a three. No good. And
it's a foul on 12, yeah.
We're going to have a foul, yeah. She was boxing out Trendle trying to get to the ball.
Courtney Bickford of Millis.
That's going to be
hooked around here.
Will be her
third. Oh, I'm sorry. Is that Aaron? Aaron Rice. I
thought it was on Bickford, too, but yep. It looks like they got Rice with something.
Yep.
Out of bounds it goes off of Millis as Bickford was trying to pick the pass off. Cho will inbound. Feeds it over to give back to Cho. And now to Doherty. Up for the jumper off the window and in. Is the Hillers offense starting to heat up perhaps?
Let's see if we get into single digits here, Tom.
It's an 11-point game. Miller will drive down and draw some contact. The Hillers keying in on the low post. Millis took advantage of low post opportunities in the third quarter.
Lauren Cho, third foul.
Kayleen Adams will inbound. Gets it over to Miller, up, no good. Loose ball collected by Trendle. Here comes Cho. Cho to Sensity. Now over to Hardenbrook. Around the horn they go. Doherty goes up for the three. It was blocked, but Trendle is there to collect and put it in. And the crowd starting to make some noise here. The Hillers are within nine.
Four straight points for the Hillers. Actually, six straight points if you include Lauren's shot at the end of the third quarter. Oh, wide open.
Bickford feeds it underneath, but unable to finish is Haley Roach. But it was knocked out of bounds off of Doherty, who was trying to collect the loose ball. Well, the Mohawks starting to miss a lot of open low post opportunities. Up to Miller. They'll drive the lane, feeds it to the corner, up for three, and no good is Adams. And it's collected by Lexi Trendle, who's just been a force under the boards tonight. Doherty drives in, up for the shot, no good. And Millis has it, Bickford there to collect.
And you're right, there was a lot of contact there.
Sure.
Rice drives in up with the left hand, and she'll draw a push.
I'm looking at Coach Greco, and he's got his hands again facing the – I got to say that the foul was called. There was contact. This is an observation, not a home style discount here or comment, but the foul was called before the contact, almost as if it was anticipated. That's not really good refereeing right there. And Coach Greco, I think, is with me on that one.
Oh, I'd have to agree. It's been on and off officiating tonight. Miller, top of the perimeter.
Oh, there's a nice steal.
What a strip there by Hardenbrook. Great steal. Here comes Cho. Cho trying to get it to Sensini, and smart move there. Nowhere to go with it. She put it off the foot of Aaron
Rice.
Great ball distribution up, and can't finish is on the Hardenbrook attempt. Here comes Millis. Over to Rice, driving in, up and in she goes.
That's a tough exchange there. That's a four-point swing there where the Hiller's missing a layup, and then Lauren Cho in a tough spot with three fouls. She really didn't want to pick up a fourth.
Lead for Millis back to 11. Sensini trying to change that. That's no good. And the Mohawks get it back. Here comes Rice. Driving the lane. Up. No good. Millis
nice
rebound.
Block.
And Bickford tries to go for the putback. But Kylie Hardenbrook says, no, you don't. Cho to Sensini. Now to Doherty. Inside to Trendle. And Trendle draws contact.
Millis coach Dave Fallon looking for a travel call, as I can hear through my headphones some of the Millis parents as well. Kind of a, can hear it here. They're still talking about the travel.
We got Georgia Jelasco with her second. Hillers will inbound. 5:10 left to go. Hillers trailing by 11. Good feed to Trendle up. No good. Ball batted around. And Lauren Murphy trying to collect, but contesting her was Abby Miller, and now the ball's just being knocked around constantly. Here comes Caroline Mundy, who gets away with it. Mundy feeds it to Miller, off the glass and in. What a sequence of events that was.
Wow, tough exchange there. The Hillers were knocking on the door to get the game kind of heading their direction, and they've lost their grip a little bit here.
Stolen away by Miller, and then it's knocked out of bounds. And actually, looks like a foul. We're going to get a push. That'll be on Lauren Murphy. It's her first. Kayleen Adams going to take her time here. Time is on the Mohawks' side. Feeds it out. Mundy launches the shot. No good. And it's knocked out of bounds off of Jelasco.
Nope. 32-19 Millis, 4:28 left in the fourth. Hillers need to make a very quick run here, one possession at a time. There's no such thing as a 13-point bucket, but they need a bucket right here, I'd say.
They need a few of them.
Yep.
Cho takes it up. Over to Fassbender. Around the defender, out to Hardenbrook.
Uh-oh.
Feeds it across to Lulu, up for the shot, no good.
Nice play.
And a great rebound there. Hardenbrook tries to turn around, that's no good. And the Mohawks are going to have it. Jelasco wrapped it up, but we have a foul. And was it against the Hillers? There was some contact between Hardenbrook and Jelasco, and it looks like it is.
Hardenbrook, that's a heck of an effort on her part. A couple offensive rebounds, couldn't get it to fall. Basically diving and kind of giving up her body for that one, but got her money's worth on that foul.
Third foul on Hardenbrook. Team sixth for the Hillers.
Three on one. What's a?
Here comes Jewett. Feeds it underneath. Up, off the glass, and in is Jelasco.
No basket.
Oh, late wave off here.
Unusual.
Well, they called a very late push. So I guess you could wave that one off.
I'm not really sure what happened there.
Well, actually, they...
They allowed it.
Well, it's still up on the scoreboard. So I'm assuming they counted it. I guess it was after the fact, perhaps?
Grace Stewart with a foul after that. That's my interpretation. It's hard to say for sure.
So some unnecessary roughness after the bucket. Shota Fossbender driving down the lane, and it's stripped away. Jalasco was there to take it away. Jewett driving up. It'll roll off the rim into the hands of McDonald. Here comes Cho. Over to Fossbender, launches a three. That's no good. Off the fingertips of Miller and out of bounds. Or was it? No, looks like they called it out on Trendle.
Millers can't fault their effort. Just coming up against a tough defensive squad in Millis here. Just anytime they get any kind of, the one time, you know, a few minutes ago had a little bit of mojo going, they just couldn't get over the hump, and then a couple quick hoops by Millis, and then all of a sudden they're down by 15 points again.
And it seems like for Millis, just starting this game, they've been flying all over the floor, and they have not gotten tired. Impressive stuff as Abby Miller misses the three, and the Hillers have it. Here comes Cho, feeds it over to Fossbender. She'll kick it out. Up for three is Hardenbrook. That's no good.
Ooh, that's a foul.
And then we're going to have a foul on the rebound attempt, a hard push against, I believe, Millis.
Kayleen Adams, number 11.
Although nothing foul-wise is guaranteed in this game.
Well, I really, you know, in our position up here on the perch, we try not to be too critical of the refs, but I've called a couple of the boys' games this past week, and outstanding referees, we didn't really talk about the refs, but here we're kind of put in a position where we have to at least acknowledge that there's been some tough calls.
Put back off the miss. Fossbender shot is no good by Trendle.
Tough calls, I mean missed calls.
And the Hiller is running out of time. Yeah, it's been a tough game on many fronts tonight. But
that's not to say that the refs are causing the score to be 34-19 Millis, but well, that's a travel right there, I think.
Money to Jalasco, and they do get it for the travel. Well, I think when you have a lot of missed shots, a lot of rebound attempts, a lot of battles for the ball, there's always going to be a lot of missed calls, and there'll probably be some wrong calls.
Well, you know, it's okay for a few, but when there's an anticipated call a half a second before there's actually contact, that's kind of hard to
right
support, you know, the ref in that situation. And I'm sure they're nice guys and everything, but
and Ellie launches the three, no good. And it's collected by Hedstrom, but then stripped away by Miller. Millis up by 15, and they are looking to go to 7-1. 1:47 and counting left to go. Rice feeds it back to Miller. Now Adams, they're just trying to burn some clock here. Adams will put it up, no good. Collected by McDonald. Hedstrom will take it up, feeds it to the corner, up, no good is Iannelli. The Mohawks get it back as Rice is there. Abby Miller will take her time. Well, tough loss for the Hillers it's going to be tonight, but plenty of basketball left to be played.
Absolutely, and Millis got to tip your hat to them. That's a heck of a team they have here.
The drive and the lay-in, no good by Adams, and we get a foul.
A one-on-one situation for...
And it will be against Millis, so they have reached the limit. The freshman, Annabelle Sensini, at the line.
I'm just guessing she's Amelia's sister. Same last name, is going to run with that. But it's good to see...
I'd say that'd be a good guess.
Annabelle getting the game here, get some playing time as a freshman. Got some height there, huh?
The front end of the one-and-one is no good. And the Mohawks have it. Less than a minute left to go now. Up next for the Hillers, they'll be at Norwood. They'll be against Medfield right here in the Hillers Athletic Center, and then they'll be at Norwood. No good on the shot there, collected by Miller, who's been a force all night for the Mohawks in the low post, and then we have a foul call. Make that a timeout call to keep it in Millis possession. 39 seconds left to go. Well, the Hillers, they had a rough night offensively, but I think there's certainly a lot of talent on this team. Some good speed, good hustle.
They just have to get the offense going.
Yeah, offensively. And if you look at the Millis' score, they've only got 34 points. That's not exactly a big offensive output on their part, although they've had some really nice plays. They're just a tough team all around. But tip your hat to, you know, if looking for some positives, the Hillers played tough D on a really tough team. And they'll get another shot at Millis a few weeks down the road. And 3-2, not a bad start for the Hillers. Again, they're a young team, starting right. Three sophomores. And last year, as I recall, you know, a lot of these players, they were freshmen. And so hopefully as they get their legs under them as the season goes along, they'll steady the ship, as I say. So.
Well, I expect many better nights than this for the Hillers, that's for sure.
Yeah, 19 points, tough output.
I don't think you'll see that too much more often by this Hillers team. There's a very bright future. Mundy with possession, launches the buzzer beater, no good. As the shot clock was about to expire, out of bounds it goes. It was last touched by a Hiller, says the official.
29 seconds left, shot clock is off. Oof, tough foul on number 25.
Oof. And we'll have an inbound violation.
Mia Molinari wiped out the Hiller. I mean, I could see it from here, I could feel it from here.
Well, no harm at this point for Millis. Feeds it in to McDonald. The kick out to Hedstrom, who drives in up for the shot. No good. Loose ball. A number of
nice
players
play.
Get wrapped up with it. And coming out of the pack with it was Sensini. And then we're going to get a hold call against Molinari, I believe.
Number 25, yep. Getting her money's worth. Just getting into the game here. Freshman, 5'8". Aggressive.
Maggie Hedstrom at the line. The junior trying to get into the scorebooks for her first time tonight. Front end of the 1-1, and she hits. Where was that all night?
Is that a rhetorical question? I would have to say the same thing, but nice rotation, good routine. And that's a nice job by Maggie. Nice rotation, and just in general, free throw shooting, so critical. And if the Hillers had a reasonable free throw shooting, they could have been within striking distance, but that didn't really help when they went from, I don't know, you have the stats, but it was it's well below 50% at the line for the Hillers.
Well, Grace Hedstrom dribbles out the clock, and that's going to do it. The Millis Mohawks take down the Hillers, 34-21. The Hillers will look to pick themselves up this coming Friday when they take on Medfield. And you'll be able to catch that game on HCAM. A rough night offensively for Hopkinton, but as you said, Steve, a young team and you can't win them all.
Yeah, congratulations to both teams. Early in the season for both. You can see them shaking hands and hugging each other at the end of the game. Let's not forget about those kind of that part of the game. They see these girls know each other. They probably played a lot of AAU against each other, youth ball. So, great time doing the game with you, Tom, and we'll be doing more this season, too, for sure.
Absolutely. The Hillers fall to 3-2. Millis now 7-1 for our HCAM crew. We thank you for watching Hopkinton Hillers girls basketball on HCAM. Final score for the final time, Millis over Hopkinton, 34-21. Have a good night. We'll talk to you again soon.